This is one of my favorite phone cases. You're so out of light. You make me bad and I don't know why. But that's what I like about ya. Yeah, that's what I like about ya. I'm out of my mind. You got me running all the red lights. But that's what I like about ya. Yeah, that's what I like about ya. Hi guys, it's Bree here and today it is Halloween, the day that I'm uploading this. Or at least for me. And basically I'm just going to be attempting to recreate some Halloween slimes from probably the most popular slime in the world, glitter slimes. They didn't all work. They didn't all turn out the best, but yeah. So the first slime I'm going to be recreating is Witch's Brew, which is basically a mixture of white and clear glue. And now I'm going to dye whatever shade of green this is. And then something kind of bad happened.
Oh my god, I just dropped my phone in glue. Holy sh**.
This is one of my favorite phone cases.
Okay, it is 5 minutes later. The phone is fine. I put on a different phone case. It seems fine, it seems unaffected by me dropping it in glue.
So back on topic, now I'm just adding the activator that I made, which is a mixture of borax and warm water. And I'm just going to mix that up until I get the desired consistency that I want. So now that I've activated it, I'm going to add in a mixture of green flown beads, some googly eyes and some just clear beads, and now I'm just going to mix it up. So the next slime is called Enchanted Boba Tea. Now this is a clear slime and now I'm going to add some red and blue food dye to make purple. And yes, there is food dye all over my fingers because, I don't know, I'm just a really messy person. Also, I ended up adding too much blue compared to the original one. Yeah. Also, I'm going to be using laundry detergent since this is a clear slime, just because I think it personally clears up better using laundry detergent, but yeah, any activator is fine. So now I'm just kneading it or mixing it, and as you can see, the colour is a little bit lighter when it's not cleared up, so yeah. Now I'm adding some sugar beads and some pastel purple sprinkles and mixing that up. So I'm going to add mini black pom-poms to represent the boba pearls, which I do not have. But yeah, the original uses boba pearls. If you would like to see what the slime looks like when it is completely clear, then come over here and just have a look at it on my slime account. Now back to the video. The next slime that we're going to be recreating is called Pumpkin Crumb Cake. And so now I'm just going to start off by dyeing a thick white base this bright orange colour. Now it has to be overactivated, but not a lot, just because otherwise it will melt in the next step, so yeah, it has to be overactivated. And now we're getting instant snow, I think it's called, but we're just going to tip out a bunch of the powder, and this was kind of hard to get out of this container because it was
weirdly designed. And now I'm just mixing in the slime with the snow, which, I mean, I honestly didn't think it was going to work, but then you just have to keep going for like 10 minutes and it works. Although, turns out I didn't do it properly, I guess, because this slime didn't end up being very similar to the one I was trying to recreate. But you know what? I didn't say these were going to work. I said I was going to try and recreate them. So, this is my inspired slime by that one. So yeah, then I just added in some clay chunks and some orange foam beads and mixed them in. I hope you guys enjoyed the video, and I hope you have an awesome Halloween, no matter what you're doing, if you're on your own, going trick-or-treating, having a party, watching scary movies, whatever you're doing, I hope you have a great time, and I will see you next time. Bye!